إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أياما ليس لي منه مجير، بعفوك من عذابك أستجير، أنا العبد المقر من كل ذنب وأنت يا سيد المولى الغفور. فإن عذبتني فبسوء فعلي، وإن تغفر لي فأنت منه جدير. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he deserved to be praised and sending blessings and salutations upon the last messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the household of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to anyone who will follow the guidance and the hadiya of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibad Allah, a believer is a someone who always, he is in a state of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah is in control of all our affairs. He will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah, it is in control of good and also in control of bad. He has to believe that the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, khayrihi wa sharrihi min Allah, the evil and the good, it is also coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A believer, it is a someone who believes the wording of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, wa'alam anna al-umma law ijtama'u ala an yanfa'uka bi shay'in lam yanfa'uka illa bi shay'in qad katabahu Allahu lak. A believer is someone who believes the wordings of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, and know that if all the nations were gathered together for them to benefit you with anything, they will not benefit you except on the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written and ordained for you. And again, when he says, wa'alam anna al-umma law ijtama'u ala an yadhurruka bi shay'in, and know that if all the nations were, all of them were to gather together so that they will harm you with something, they will not harm you except on the things that Allah has ordained and written against you. A believer is a someone who believes when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say to the pagans of the Mecca, قُلْ إِنْ أَرَادَنِيَ اللَّهُ قُلْ مَا تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. Tell me, O you pagans, tell me, O you non-believers, that you invoke and call beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنْ أَرَادَنِيَ اللَّهُ بِضُرِّنْ هَلْ هُنَّ كَاشِفَاتُ ضُرِّ. If Allah intended me that harm will come to me, that do you think all of these idols will be able to remove the harm of Allah? أو أَرَادَنِي بِرَحْمَةٍ. Oh Allah intended me that mercy and rahmah will come upon me. هَلْ هُنَّ مُمْسِكَاتُ رَحْمَتِي. Will they be able to withdraw the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You as a believer, you have to believe that whatever that is going around the world, it is with the hikmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If all the nations, they will gather together so that they want to benefit Muslims, none of them they will be able to benefit except what Allah has written for us. And if all of them, other nations, UN, UK, or USA, or any other nations, they will gather together so that they want to harm Muslims, they will not be able to harm them except on the things that Allah has written and ordained for us to go against us. That's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was commanded for him, قُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهِ. Say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for me. حَسْبِي Allah, the words of the messengers. حَسْبِي Allah, the words of the prophets. حَسْبِي Allah, the words of the pious people. حَسْبِي Allah, the words of the believers. حَسْبِي Allah, the words when no one have anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. حَسْبِي Allah وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ, the words of remembrance when people are oppressed. حَسْبِي اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ, the words of remembrance when someone is sick. حَسْبِي اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ, the words of remembrance when someone wants guidance. حَسْبِي اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ, the words of remembrance when everything and everyone it is against you. حَسْبِي اللَّهُ حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ. قالها إبراهيم حين ألقي في النار, وقالها محمد حين قالوا إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبنا الله. إبراهيم عليه السلام, he said these words when everyone and everything was against him, including his own family, including his own father. Everyone was against. What happened to them? They threw into the fire. And what was the result? For him saying, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ, Allah is narrating and telling us, قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمُ. We've told and inspired the fire to be cool and peace to Ibrahim alayhi salam. What was the result for him saying حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ when everything and everyone was against him? Allah is explaining to us, وَأَرَادُوا بِهِ كَيْدًا فَجَعَلْنَاهُمُ الْأَقْصَرِينَ. They intended that harm will fall into Ibrahim, but we've made them to be the losers. Everyone they're against our brothers and sisters in Palestine, Allah is inspiring to us, وَأَرَادُوا بِهِ كَيْدًا. They intended the harm to fall into Ibrahim, فَجَعَلْنَاهُمُ الْأَقْصَرِينَ, and we've made them to be the losers. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made those non-believers in the time of Ibrahim to be losers, and the same Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will make the losers anyone who is against Muslims. And Allah, and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وَقَالَهَا مُحَمَّدْ and حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حِينَ قَالُوا, when the people said to them, إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ, people are gathered so that they want to finish you, all Muslims, فَخْشَوْهُمْ, fear them. But rather the Muslim, فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا, their iman increased. And they said, حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ, Allah is sufficient for us. Allah is sufficient for us Muslims. We don't need any weapons. Our weapons, as Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, الدُّعَاءُ سِلَاحُ الْمُؤْمِنِ. Dua, it is a weapon. It is a tool of a mu'min. وَقَالَهَا مُحَمَّدُ. Muhammad said these words, حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ. And imagine my brothers and sisters, just yesterday finished the battle of Uhud. 70 Muslims were already killed, and in these 70 Muslims that were already killed are the strongest warriors in that battle. And now Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he returned back to Medina. Muslims were winning and now they're losing. And imagine, people are going back to Medina, and in this battle A lot of Muslims got injured, including our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He got injured. He was even unable to walk. Abdul Rahman ibn Auf came in and aiding Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and carrying Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on his shoulder. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was feeling the fatigue and they returned back to Medina. And early in the morning, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is calling for another jihad. Imagine in this, my brothers and sisters, some of them, they've got 70 wounds. I'm not saying any wounds or injuries, but wounds from swords. Everyone, they've listened to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they went. And this is called the Battle of Hamra'ul Asad. They went to the place called Dhul Hulayfa. As soon as they reach there, people are gathered, and on the other side, the non-believers are already gathered. And what they said, Abu Sufyan, he says, we've already killed the strongest warrior in this battle. The only thing that now we can do, let's go back and finish them. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Muslims, they came and they've reached this place, and the Bedouins are coming and telling that, listen, people are gathered. The only reason that they gathered, it is to come and finish you. فَخْشَوْهُمْ Fear them. It is exactly now. Media, news and everything, they're telling us to fear what is going on. But rather in that time, Muslim فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا Their iman increased. And they said, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ Allah is sufficient for us. Allah is sufficient for you. When the nations are against you, Allah is sufficient for you. When your community is against you, Allah is sufficient for you. When your family it is against you, Allah is sufficient for you. When you fall in sick, Allah is sufficient for you. When you want guidance, Allah is sufficient for you. When you're oppressed, Allah is sufficient for you. When you don't have no one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, aqulu ma sami'tum wa astaghfiru Allah li wa lakum min kulli dhanbin fastaghfiruh. الحمد لله لا يحصى له عدد ولا يحيط به الأقلام والمدد وأحمد الله منه العون والرشد حمدا لربي دائما في السر والجهر في الدارين مسترد. Most of us, we know and we see with our naked eyes. On our social medias, it might be on our WhatsApp or Twitters or any social medias that you're using, how our brothers and sisters are suffering. Sometimes we see some of the images, we're really shocked, we can't even watch. And now look, when you're really shocked, how you have to respond. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says to the Sahabas, كَيْفَ أَنْعَمْ How am I going to be at ease? While وَصَاحِبُ الْقَرْنِ قَدْ انْتَقَمَ الْقَرْنِ While Israfil already put the trumpet on his mouth, how am I going to be on at ease? Israfil is just waiting for the trumpet to blow. And all the Sahabas were really shocked. Everyone was shaking. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he saw what the Sahabas are going. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, what can we say? And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, قُولُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ Say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for us. When you see these images, horror images, horrific images, terrible images that you can't even imagine, you can't even look. The only thing that you have to say, it is making dua for them and also saying, Allah is sufficient for us. Allah, as Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, in hadith al-ifk, Aisha radiallahu anha, people in that time, they've told Aisha she committed adultery. And in that time, everyone was against Aisha radiallahu anha, including her family. Because of why? Because of the munafiqeen spreading lies. In our time, because of the media spreading lies against Muslims. Aisha radiallahu anha, she was in a state that to the beyond Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not talking to Aisha. Lies was spreading in Medina. And suddenly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the seventh heaven, He's revealing the ayat to show that Aisha radiallahu anha, she was clean. When she was asked what dua she was making, she said she was saying, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ When the media, when the social media, when the government, when the people, when the weapons are as strong against us, our responsibility and us to respond back, it is us raising our hands to the sky. And the one who gave them the weapons, it is the one who gave us the dua, and it is us to say, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Allah, it is a sufficient for us. So remember, always, when we don't have no one, then we have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهَذَا وَصَلُّوا وَسَلِّمُوا عَلَى رَسُولِكُمْ كَمَا أَمَرَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل وسلم على محمد في الأولين، وصل وسلم على محمد في الآخرين، وصل وسلم على محمد في النبيين، وصل وسلم على محمد في المرسلين، وصل وسلم على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. وعنا بفضلك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين. اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم انصر إخواننا في غزة، اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم انصر إخواننا في غزة. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. وأقم الصلاة، إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا.